Hello, my name is Jackie McNamara, and I'm going to give you my all-time Celtic 11 that I've played with. Starting in goals, which is a difficult one to start for me. I think between Gordon Marshall and possibly Rab Douglas. I think Big Rab just shades it. His performances, getting us to the UEFA Cup final that season, for me, just edged out Gordon. In my time there, Rab was very influential in the games leading up to getting to the final, the UEFA Cup. So I'm going to start in goals with Rab Douglas. Right back, I'm going to go with Didier Gatt. Strange decision. So most of the time he played his career maybe right wing back, but the reason why I found myself on the bench a lot of the time when Martin came in, his performances and his standard he set when he came in and basically took my position. I found it really hard to get back in. I think the standard that he set when he came there, eventually Martin put him back to right back. So right back, I will go with Didier Gatt. Centre halves, starting with the right hand side, will be Johan Malbier, who was brought in by Dr. Joe Vengos, and I think his initial impact, he was started off as a midfielder. He came in and was absolutely fantastic, a real mainstay, first name in the team sheet. Johan was a real leader in the park. So I would have him centre half in the 4-4-2. Next to him would be Tom Boyd. Tom played a good number of the season, centre half under Tommy Burns when I first went there. Again, terrific servant to Celtic. Great guy in the dressing room, and his performances and his consistency over the years was fantastic. So he'd be my other centre half. Left back is toss up between Tosh McKinley and Alan Thompson. I'm going to go Alan Thompson. I know it's not the defensive side, but for me, Alan Thompson should be in my starting 11. His performances throughout his time at Celtic when he came in, again, scored some crucial goals in Old Firm games, as well as European games getting to Seville. So Alan Thompson will put in at right back, left back, although he'll not be too happy about that. On the right hand side, I will go with possibly Stylian Petrov. I'll go with Stylian on the right hand side. Again, he was brought in, I think John Barnes came in, and it took him a bit of time to settle into the team, but his goals over the seasons that he was there, his attitude, when he first came in, he looked a little bit overweight, and he got his fitness up, and his energy and his desire to keep going. I think he was just a terrific all-round midfielder. So start with Stirling in there. Alongside him would be Paul McStay. When I first came to Celtic, you see him on the telly, and his nickname's a maestro, but I think his performances is one guy that I've played with, that he can actually dictate the level of play. He takes the game with scruff of the neck, he always wants the ball. A great leader, a great guy, but a really, really fantastic midfield player all round. So for me, Paul McStay in there. Next to him would be Paul Lambert. Again, similar to Paul McStay. Fantastic player, read the game well, he came back for Dortmund, and his real inspiration is winning the league for the first time in 1998. He scored a crucial goal here against Rangers in the 2-1 victory. So I think the two Pauls in the centre midfield, and just to side of them would be Liberty Moravcik. Lubo came in, Dr. Joe as well, knew him very well. The most ability I've ever seen in a player, right foot, left foot, it was just incredible when he came in, 32, 33 year of age, but his fitness and his all-round ability was just incredible, what he could do with a ball. So for me, Lubo would be in that midfield. The two strikers, starting with the main man, which is Henrik Larsson, I think, undoubtedly the best player ever to come into Scotland. Playing Scottish football, his attitude, the desire, his goal-scoring threat, but his all-round play. I think he's, as I said, he's the best player ever to play in Scotland for me. And the last pick would be Chris Sutton. Along with Henrik, he was a really intelligent player, so he could play anywhere. You could slot him in midfield, at the back, but a real intelligent footballer. Scored some great goals and really influential in us doing well. A real good servant to Celtic like the rest of them. So my last pick would be Chris Sutton to go beside Henrik up front. So that's my all-time Celtic 11 that I've played with. Hope you agree with that. That's just my opinion, and I think that team would do well just now, especially in, might not be the best defensively with Alan Thompson at left back, but I think Alan had to be in that team, get the merits, you know, the service he gave to Celtic. So that's mine. Thank you.